Today's scripture lessons come from Psalm 35, verses 1 through 8, and Matthew chapter 5, 38, 48. So I strongly urge everyone to get out your Bibles and follow along to make sure I don't say something wrong. Harass these hecklers, God. Punch these bullies in the nose. Grab a weapon, anything at hand. Stand up for me. Get ready to throw the spear. Aim the javelin at the people who are out to get me. Reassure me, let me hear you say, I'll save you. When those thugs try to knife me in the back, make them look foolish. Frustrate all those who are plotting my downfall. Make them like cinders in a high wind, with God's angel working the bellows. Make their road lightless and mud slick, with God's angel on their tails. Out of sheer cussedness, they set a trap to catch me. For no good reason, they dug a ditch to stop me. Surprise them with your ambush. Catch them in the very trap they set, the disaster they planned for me. Here's another old saying that deserves a second look. Eye for eye, tooth for tooth. Is that going to get us anywhere? Here's what I propose. Don't hit back at all. If someone strikes you, stand there and take it. If someone drags you into court and sues for the shirt off your back, gift wrap your best coat and make a present of it. And if someone takes unfair advantage of you, use the occasion to practice the servant life. No more tit for tat stuff. Live generously. You're familiar with the old written law, love your friend and its unwritten companion. Hate your enemy. I'm challenging that. I'm telling you to love your enemies. Let them bring out the best in you, not the worst. When someone gives you a hard time, respond with the energies of prayer. For then you are working out of your true selves, your God-created selves. This is what God does. He gives his best, the sun to warm and the rain to nourish, to everyone. Regardless, the good and bad, the nice and nasty. If all you do is love the lovable, do you expect a bonus? Anybody can do that. If you simply say hello to those who greet you, do you expect a medal? Any run-of-the-mill sinner does that. In a word, what I'm saying is, grow up. You're kingdom subjects. Now live like it. Live out your God-created identity. Live generously and graciously toward others the way God lives towards you.